FB. So,
ayan, now it comes to the B. The formula for bending using Euler's. Euler's, ha? Euler's. So, a while ago, we have FCEN. FCEN for polo. This for beam. What is the formula? So 1.2. No, that is the formula. 1.2 times the E min. No? E min. Then, so E min is given. So E min is 1.242. 1.2. So E min is 1.242 times 10 to the then R of B squared. This is what? So 10.04 squared. Okay. So how much is that? 1.2 times 1.242 divided by answer squared. We have 14.79. Let us use 14.8. 14.8. Okay. Then solve for alpha. We can now solve for alpha. Now, so for the beam, like this. Similar to that. Similar to that formula. Similar formula. If we compute that, the answer is 0.9879, or let us say 0.99. Really start 0.99. Oh yeah, very very small factor. 0.99. Okay. So therefore, we can also compute for this is compression, this is flexure. Because why? Because again, we are dealing with two types of load: axial and flexure. This is compressive axial. This is bending. So F, F, B, N. Right. Okay. So therefore, 2.94 times 0.99. So 2.94 times 0.99. How much is this? Okay. does T. Let us compute for the amplification. Amplification factor. Amplification factor is how much is the flexure scaled down or scaled up against axial. So because we cannot just add axial and flexure component, there must be some scale up or scaling down. No? So factor, that is what we call factor. Amplification factor. Okay. That is the meaning of this factor. Let us compute based on the axis we can want. We have what? F, C, E, X. No? There is only one axis. There is only one x-axis. X-axis. So let us use what? A L over E. So the x-axis, or the x-axis with this already solved. K L over this equal to L E over, because K is 1. Because K is 1. That's why it is equal. They are not usually equal. So F C E X X axis. Meaning X axis. So again, the formula a while ago, we already used that formula. A 2 because of this value. We know that this value is this formula. Right? Corresponding formula. So 1, 2, what is E? E mean? 1, 2, 4, 2 times 10 to the 3. This one. Okay? And therefore, we divide it by this. 55.2 squared. How much is this? This is 1.56. And therefore we can solve for amplification factor. Let us use the symbol amplification factor. Formula. Let's copy this formula. We already have this last semester, but we have it here now. We will divide by amplification factor. Let's take this. Oopsie. Okay. This is the formula. Finding out this value, right? Video, this is what? KSI. So KSI, so let us multiply by what? Area. Multiply by area. So that the same area, so we have what? So this is KSI. KSI, PU is in already. We already erased PU. PU is about what? PU is 12.8, I think. PU is 12.8. So 1 divided by IPS. No, IPS. So KSI times area is IPS. 1 minus PU is 12.8 divided by this one 1.56 times area. How much is the area? So already we have 38.44. Okay. 38.44. How much is it? Final, correct? Decision, equation, no?